My name is Antonio.
Hi, my name is Layla.
My name is JD.
My name is Jason.
Hi, my name is Jeremy.
Hi, my name is Lydia.
My name is Monia.
My name is Quantasia.
Hi, my name is Rolene.
Hi, my name is Rolt.
My name is Amina.
My name is Shanessa.
I attended an HBCU and a PWI.
I attended a PWI.
A PWI is a predominantly white institution, and for a long time in America, African Americans were not allowed to attend them. Thus, an HBCU, or historically black college or university, was born.
There's a difference in the cultural experience. There's more of a protected experience that HBCU students receive in that space than they receive at the PWI.
No, I've never felt excluded at my institution. Pretty much when I went on open house, and at midday, and when I finally got there, I just felt the family vibe instantly, and I made friends pretty quick, so I never felt isolated.
Most definitely, it was a lot of not wanting to take answers or, you know, not wanting to partner up, things like that.
Me personally, no, but I know other peers who have. Our black community at the PWI that I attended, it can definitely get elitist and has some taints of classism. So a lot of people weren't able to join in all the same activities that other students were, and sometimes they felt left out. And so a lot of times would have to make ways to let those students feel included.
At my HBCU, I never really felt excluded. What I loved about it was that it had that family vibe from day one.
When I first got there, I did feel excluded, but it wasn't the institution. It was my own exclusion. Being such a huge introvert and being thrown into a huge bed of just like social interaction, it was kind of hard to actually get into what was going on and all the different people and cultures. So I felt excluded, but it was because of myself.
I honestly feel like nobody could be excluded from my HBCU. I feel like at my school, you were always willing to find somebody that is similar to you or almost like you, have a similar background or some type of interest.
That I recall, like, I can't ever remember feeling excluded, no.
No, not even. I mean, no. I think with the merging of cultures, so with it being such a mixed population of black people, from Haitians to Jamaicans, then you could probably feel excluded in that nature. But after a while, you just kind of get immersed in it. Everybody's just together.
At my PWI, there's like a small collection of like black people that hang around. So if you hang around them, you'll feel included. But I wasn't really in that group per se. But being an athlete, I always found my home there. At my HBCU, I mean, everyone is alike, so it's easy to find your crowd. So I never felt excluded there.
I want to say there were moments where I did feel isolated. I went to an event my freshman year and I was the only black female in the room, but I did not let that hinder me from graduating. I made it my mission to want to create more diversity on campus.
Yeah, definitely. Like at a PWI, it's kind of like, at least for me, all the black people kind of hung out, right? So that in itself, I'm not gonna say that's a clique, but at a PWI, all the black people, right? And then amongst that, we had our own set of groups. And so like, I did sort of kind of, like I had my crew of friends that I hung around with, but then I was also a part of different organizations. And so we had, at my PWI, we had this thing called Black Wednesdays. So pretty much every Wednesdays, every org would come into this like common area at my school. And obviously we're separated. And because I was a part of like different orgs and things like that, I was with my clique of friends, but then I'm also with like different organizations, things like that. That's kind of as much cliquish as it was. It was kind of like that.
Were there ever any injustices done to you during your undergraduate career?
Microaggressions. Microaggressions are any type of level. I don't think anything really overt happened to me personally, but I can definitely speak to a ton of microaggressions that I experienced at my PWI. Yes, group. I can start with group projects. Usually, I majored in economics, so a lot of times I was the only black student in my class. So a lot of group discussions and group projects, I kind of felt excluded. When I was with my white peers, I felt that my voice was never heard.
At my PWI, I haven't faced any injustices that I've noticed, neither at my HBCU.
One of my best friends was mistaken for a criminal, and it was really tough, and we were being racially profiled by our own campus police. So that was an injustice I experienced, and I also experienced being only one of four black students on our student activities council, which involved 32 students. And we felt like our voices were never heard, and our advisor told, you know, I let him know of the experiences that we were having, and that we felt like our voices weren't heard. And he said that it was a card that we were pulling when it wasn't. This was my experience.
Black students attending HBCUs are more likely to feel that their institution has responded to their needs. But some may argue that PWIs have more resources.
And for what reasons did you transfer from HBCU to a PWI?
When I first enrolled in my HBCU, I was in the dual degree program, which involves 3 years at the HBCU and two at a PWI with an engineering major. So I was kind of in that path from the beginning. PWI could benefit from just more diversity. You know, there, like I said, and I believe my PWI has improved at that, but just seeing more people like you on campus would just make it feel more like home. And for HBCUs, it's really the only thing they can improve is just like the funding, because they just don't have access to the same number of materials and resources that my PWI does.
Between the late 1970s and 2010, HBCU enrollment grew. But between 2010 and 2016, black student enrollment has decreased. What does that mean for the black culture on some HBCU campuses in America?
So at my specific HBCU, that's not the case. Our numbers are steady in terms of enrollment, in terms of retention, and the number of white students attending my specific HBCU are not rising.
Currently, your school is an HBCU, still is. The university now educates about 4,000 students a year, 11% of whom are white. So it may seem like there are a lot more white students than black students on campus. Mm-hmm. How did that affect your experience and the black culture on campus?
That percentage really is just a pointless number in my opinion. Like I said, we didn't treat anybody different. We didn't exclude anybody. So those students that are white or a different ethnicity, really we don't see that. And honestly, like let's say like a sporting event, most of those students play an event, like whether it's crushing or bowling or something, or softball, something like that.
Most of what students? White students?
The white students. They'll be like on the most of them I've seen is either soccer, softball, equestrian. You know, some of the sports that some of the black students don't really play that much, and we're at their games getting just as rowdy as they are coming to the football games. Their chest is painted, our chest is painted, and it really don't matter. We just have to act stupid because for the love of the school.
What keeps a student motivated to succeed?
We know when it comes to teaching, relationship is probably 90% of students retaining the information, enjoying their experience in the classroom, those sort of things.
The entire faculty kind of played into the whole big family thing. You could go to your professors at any time for anything it is that you needed. They treated you like a person more than a student, and you could have like that real one-on-one relationship with them.
Professors were absolutely amazing, very supportive. I guess because like they see us following their footsteps, you know, they feel like they are able to like, you know, lend a hand, like let us know like, what we need to learn like along the way.
So definitely just the belief of my professors in me. And their dedication to want to see me grow.
The personal mentor that I had, she was actually a white lady, and she's part of the LGBT community, and I love her to death, like she was one of my mothers.
Now that we know more about HBCUs and PWIs, this makes me wonder, would you ever choose the opposite institution?
No.
Probably not. My experience, it made me who I am.
Definitely not. If I could do it all over again, because I love my school. No.
No, ma'am.
I could do it all over again, I would still choose the PWI because it made me who I am today. I know that I was a leader on my undergraduate campus and I helped change the culture climate there. I can do that anywhere in the world.
Well, there you have it. Whether you attend an HBCU or PWI, what keeps students going is the positive interactions with faculty. But you do need some self-motivation as well.
You need to figure out who it is that you are and what it is that you want out of your life in order to make it to graduation, because if you don't, you might end up dropping out. You might end up stuck there, changing your major 5 different times, because I changed it 3 times, but I made it. So you gotta figure out who it is that you are.
Discipline. Whether you go, any school you go to, there's always gonna be sort of a lot of distractions, and there's no one there to tell you, you know, you have to do this, that, and the third, you're pretty much on your own. So you just have to have discipline and know that you're gonna do what you came there to do.
Just a clear understanding of progression and what that looks like. I think for me, I had to learn that I wasn't gonna be the same person that I was when I got there, but that's okay. And that I just had to learn how to progress and understand and just come to understand myself.
I would say being self-assured by being confident, because honestly, regardless of where you go, whether you attend a PWI or HBCU, you need to, of course, be self-confident in what you're doing.